Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Wang. Here is the question. Factor x squared minus x minus 3 times x squared minus x minus 5 minus 3. How to solve this kind of question in general? Just to look at this part and this part. What's the difference in between these two numbers? Difference is 2. We are going to introduce a general idea to solve this kind of question. In general, we define a new variable, which is between these two numbers. How to find this new variable? Just to consider the average of these two numbers. Simplify the right-hand side, we have y equals x squared minus x minus 4. This is the new variable we need to use to simplify the first part. The next step is to rewrite this part, in terms of y. You may ask, why do we need to define a new variable? What's the good thing about this new variable? This is the expression we need to factor. We rewrite the first term, second term, in terms of the new variable. How? Here is the detail. We can rewrite negative 3 as negative 4 plus 1, which is negative 3. Negative 5 equals negative 4 minus 1, which is negative 5. Because y equals x squared minus x minus 4. Therefore, this part is y, and this part is y too. Now, we have the result. This part and this part are in terms of y now. The first one is y plus 1. The second one is y minus 1. Because the y variable is between the two numbers, the difference of these two numbers is 2. Therefore, one number is the variable plus 1. The other is the variable minus 1. Now we can use the basic algebra formula. A plus b times a minus b, which is a squared minus b squared. Therefore, this part equals y squared minus 1 squared, which is y squared minus 4. Sorry, minus 1 minus 3. Then put them together as minus 4. Now we use the formula again. Y squared minus 2 squared equals y plus 2 times y minus 2. Until now, we can replace y back in terms of x. Use this definition. Continue to simplify each part. Now we have x squared minus x minus 6, x squared minus x minus 2. These two are easy to factor. The first one equals x plus 2 times x minus 3. The second one is x plus 1 times x minus 2. This is the final answer. That's all. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.